Elsa's gonna bring my daughter back.
Two parents with broken hearts.
9-year-old boys were left to try and save her because someone else left.
Their 8-year-old daughter hit and killed by a truck at her school bus stop. The driver took off.
You're talking about 7 through 10-year-olds in pitch black dark.
Now the parents of Layla Aiken are left questioning whether later school start times could have prevented the tragedy.
I just wanted to be safer. I don't want anyone else to be kneeling by the side of the road because their child's gone.
Tonight, the Lee County School District tells NBC2 the process of changing start times is just not as simple as it sounds, even if that means some kids are getting on the bus when it is still dark outside.
NBC2's Victoria Breslow spoke with Layla's family and the school district tonight. She is live at the memorial that keeps growing for the little girl.
Yeah, as the hours pass here in Cape Coral, you can see just how dark it really is. The same darkness that Layla was sitting in right on this corner when she was hit and killed.
I mean, you're talking about 7 through 10-year-olds in pitch black dark.
Pitch black darkness is exactly why Layla Aiken's parents want later school start times in Lee County.
I just wanted to be safer.
I mean, send them in at 9 o'clock. I mean, what's the difference if they come home a little later?
Other neighbors who live nearby where the 8-year-old was killed agree.
I just think that if you were going to put anybody to start at the early times, it would be like high schoolers.
But Lee County School District spokesperson Rob Spicker says the process is a big investment.
We need hundreds of millions of dollars up front just to invest in changing school times.
Spicker says the district has more than 90,000 students and more than 90 schools, so changing one start time would affect everything else.
We'd need to triple the amount of buses we have, triple the amount of bus drivers that we have, so that every student is being moved to their school at the same time. It's a huge undertaking.
So even though changing the start times for Lee County is complex, Spicker says the district is working to condense the proximity of elementary schools because there are so many to choose from.
Right now, you might choose, when you go into the lottery, as many as a dozen or more elementary schools. But we'd like to bring that down to 5, 6, or 7, so it'll be much closer to your home. That will shorten the bus routes in those areas for those elementary schools. That can give us the opportunity to then adjust some start times.
Time now, the biggest concern, as Aiken's family and others still wait for answers. The memorial for Layla continues to grow this evening. Now, neighbors told me that they added this bench here on the side of the road so that no one has to sit on the ground like Layla did ever again. Live in Cape Coral tonight, Victoria Reslow, NBC2.
Cape Coral police tell NBC2 they have the red truck they believe hit Layla. They also have a person of interest, but they need to gather more evidence before potentially making an arrest. Detectives say neighbors' home security video has been a huge help so far, but they want more evidence. If you have any information or video that you think could be helpful, please call Cape Coral Police or Crime Stoppers.
Now, Layla's father says a service is planned for next Wednesday at Gallagher's Funeral Home from 5 to 7 p.m. Anyone is welcome. So far, funds donated online to the family surpass $52,000.